Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Heroes of Might and Magic 2. This is Descendants expansion. When we left off, we started here. I completely forget what we're actually doing. I think we're trying to find something, and we're working our way through here. So I'm assuming it's over here somewhere. I thought it was going to be this place, somewhere over here. But it is not, so we're just moving our way through. And now I gotta get this guy. It's over here. I was hoping they wouldn't fight me. Okay, that probably wasn't worth it for just gold and stuff. I need this other guy. Oops, did not mean to do that one. Double clicked. Take her back to the other side. Who's stronger? Her. So, just have her. We'll need her there. Just need to get this guy over here. Can't get there doing that. I have to go through the whirlpool first. I guess I need to go up here. Yay, thanks. I screwed that up, kind of. How far? Oh my gosh. Should have had someone else been down there. Why can I not upgrade this? I don't have a well here, nope. Move this guy towards him so he can give him these boots. So this guy can move further. You know, statue here. I am losing it. About the caster's bracelet, and I'll take that. And you can go down there, get more people for this guy. All right, get that. So this guy already has to go pretty far. As you approach the stables, the head groom appears leading a fine-looking warhorse. This steed will help speed you in your travels. Alas, his endurance will wane with a lot of heavy riding, and you must return for a fresh mount in a week. We also have many fine warhorses which could benefit mounted soldiers, but you have none we can help. wasn't too bad. Let's get that. I'm gonna need to start running here. I'm actually gonna switch her out with her. And just have this person kind of follow around. And I might use these so I can have him. I guess I should have been getting the statue. Yep. Should have got that a while ago. I'll take some knowledge. Easy enough. This one I'm not going to be fond of. An old knight appears on the steps of the gazebo. My liege, I will teach you all that I know to aid you in your travels. This is not going to be a fun one. That actually wasn't that bad. Let's do that one. The artifact. Wasn't too terrible, I guess. Gold. What we got? You come across an ornate shrine attended by a group of rotund friars. In exchange for your protection, they agree to teach you a spell, Cold Ray. Alright. Five. You find an elaborate container which houses an old vellum scroll. The runes on the container are very old, and the archery with which it was put together was stunning. As you pull the scroll out, you feel imbued with magical powers. The spell scroll gives your ability, gives you here the ability to cast the Mass Haste spell. It's not too bad. There's another place. Holy moly, I can get three places here. What is going on here? It's kind of suspicious to me. Let's get this first. Town portal, that one's pretty good. I mean, I can do that to any town, isn't it? Because then I can go there, and then come back up here. I'll take that. What I need right there. I'm pretty sure that would end it. Well, now I don't need him over there at all, so I'm gonna have him come up here and just chill again until I find stuff. Sure. Here. She's my second best person. Okay. Alright, so that's two... Wait, which... Gold? Brown. I'm assuming this one's brown. That's orange. There's the brown. Upon your approach, the tree opens its eyes and delay on adventure. Allow me to teach you what I've learned a little over the ages. Guess I'll do that one. Maybe I'll give that vellum scroll to her. Let me just sit him in here. Okay. Oh, wow. Hold up. Back up. That doesn't really help. Teleport would be a good one. But he can't learn that, can he? Sure. It's gonna take you forever to get there anyway, so... A visit and a prayer at the temple raises your troops' morale. As you drink the sweet water, you gain luck for their next battle. Too bad I can't find, like, that one. Oh, thank God, there we go. Oof. I don't think that was actually too bad. I thought that was gonna be a lot worse. Should need her. I should have read it first. Mine would be a good one, just generally. Anti-magic would have been not really useful. Am I still blocked off here? Oh, thank God she can reach it. You enter a tent and see an old woman gazing into a magic gem. She looks up and says, "In my travels, I've learned much in the way of arcane magic. A great oracle taught me his skill. I have the answer you seek for the brown. Keyword is dwarven. Magical barrier. Brown barrier stands before, tall before you, blocking your way. Runes on the arch speak. Arch read, speak, and you may pass." Was it dwarven? I already forget. Oops. As you speak the magic word, the glowing barrier dissolves into nothingness. Oh no, I hate genies. An Orcish witch doctor living in a hut deepens your knowledge of magic by showing you how to cast stones, read portents, and decipher the intricacies of chicken's entrails. Oops, I hit the wrong button there. Man, that sucks, because that's a tough fight. I'm going to lose some people. See fleas. Nope. Like I said, I hate genies. They took out half of my people from just doing that. Mass curse, that doesn't help. Take that. Holy moly, that was so... Oh my gosh. It's gonna be this guy, but probably gonna try to save. Sneak past that guy. The brother admits you to see the master of the house. He trains you in the 4 skills a hero should know. Not too bad. Just need one of these people following him. I think I want... I don't know. I think this is gonna be my problem, is I'm trying to figure out how to do this the easiest way. This is the end of the line here. Should have gone for the thing first. Wait, which one is this? Old Traveler's Tent. So that means I can just send her back up there. Actually, how much? He has just enough spell power. I can sneak back up there and switch. Paladin. I'm gonna say it like 10 times because I apparently don't know how to remember it. Paladin. Edgewood. Paladin. Paladin. Let's get that done. Okay, I'm gonna send her in here. Oh no. You're gonna be kidding me, right? Obama screwed that up. Buckler. Where's she at? Since he has that, I'm gonna just use him. But I do want him to come down here. Switch out. I will probably keep him, though. Not through them. There's dragons right there. How strong are those dragons? Lots. Great. Along the remains of a burnt witch lies a beautiful brooch, intricately designed. Approaching the corpse with caution, you add the brooch to your inventory. The witch's brooch of magic increases your spell power by 3. I don't think I need that, especially since the dragon is the guy I will be fighting. That actually worked out incredibly well for me. Skip that for now. Please tell me it's just... What is that little hammer thing? It's gonna go down that way and all the way around. Because that's the last one. Again, wasn't too bad. I just want to see what this scroll is. Resurrect, that's a pretty good one, but he's pretty weak on that front. This will be interesting. I'll let this guy run in here. Grab all them. Movement. Neither one of them really have great movement. Just have her sit there. That's just lots? That seems more like hordes. Oof. I mean, I had to do it. I shouldn't have done that. Don't need that. Grab all this stuff. Actually, I can do this. What's that town called? You know what I really should have done? Don't want to do that. Elwyn. Oh, Sporgigal. He's got mine. There they are. Don't care. I'll take that. I want that. Really? I do want this one. I guess that's a good one for me. I don't care about summoning. Resurrect, secure, town portal, mass haste. You have anything? Yeah, you just got the brooch. Now I need him to come down here. I think my best guy is going to be the... I want that. That's probably something good. Thank you for not wanting to fight. Wasn't actually as bad as I thought it was gonna be. Ooh, thanks for the spell power that I don't need. You come upon a battle where a paladin has been mortally wounded by a group of zombies. He asks you to take his hammer and finish what he started. As you pick it up, it begins to hum, and then everything becomes a blur. The zombies lie dead, the hammer dripping with blood. You strap it to your belt. The holy hammer increases your attack skill by 5. Oh my gosh. 18 attack skill. That is ridiculous. go to these two places one last time. And Blade. Should have had one of them standing over here. Blade. 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 My final battle, but I think I'm gonna get this with at least how many dwarves I have. I don't even think if it's a ton of dragons. I have to sit here for one turn. I'm gonna keep him right there just in case I forget. I think it was Blade. Yep. Alright, well, it's up to this guy now. What's that place called? Edgewood. I should only need one spell. This is it. The moment of truth. I mean, I have enough people for, like, everything. A great black dragon stands before you. It speaks in a surprisingly soft voice, saying, "The elves believe they have sent another hero to reclaim their prize. I believe they have sent me another meal." Oh, I'm so happy they're all together, too. I was hoping it would say something like, "Oh no." The fabled gold bow of the elves lie here in the dust. You take it and journey back to the elven towns. They shower you with their graciousness, and the king promises that his people aid you whenever you seek help. The gold bow eliminates the 50% penalty for your troops shooting past obstacles. You have found the golden bow. Your quest is complete.
Against Harrendale's main territory. One way or the other, this long feud will soon be at an end.
Alright, thank you. Well, I guess I should say, when we come back, we're going to come back to the epic battle. So, thank you everyone for watching, and I'll see everyone in the next video.